chapter 30, verse 6. And this is where David actually came back, and they went out to battle. When they came back, his military, his army, they came back, all the wives and their children were taken captive. And the Bible says that all the military just turned against David. They wanted to stone him. But it's awesome because the Bible says there's a but, and I love when it says but. David found strength in the Lord his God. I don't know if you're weary this morning. I don't know what kind of trial you're going through. I don't even know if you have any trials going on right now. I ask you to ask this question to yourself. If you're not going through something right now, maybe you need to check your walk with the Lord. Because if you're not going through something, that means that guess what? The enemy's like, I don't even want to waste my time on that person. You see? But when you're having circumstances out of your control, sometimes family will come against you. Did you know that? My own family came against me this week, and I'm thinking, wow. But the Bible always backs it up. The Bible says a prophet is not welcome in his own home. Did you know that? That means someone that's sharing the good news, you're not going to be welcome in your own home. Because guess what? Your own family thinks that you are the enemy, which they're blinded by the enemy. Amen? You know, as we start up this sermon, I know it's a series we're going through. Pastor Renee gave a great example last week. He talked about justification. He talked about sanctification. He talked about calling. And ultimately, what we're trying to do is get to the goal, which is glorification, right? We glorify the Lord. And so Pastor Renee, he actually said, okay, I have a lot of material to send it to you. And I'm like, okay, Pastor, thank you. But you know, Pastor Renee, sometimes he has a problem like me working the computer. So he sends me all this paperwork, and the paperwork's turned sideways. So I'm looking at my tablet, and every time I'm turning it, my neck is turning. And it's going like this. And I'm like, before you know it, I'm in the bed turning around. And I'm like, Pastor, I call him. Pastor, I'm sorry, but I can't see this. You got to send it back to me. And I thank God that Pastor Renee is so diligent in giving those items to us. Because sometimes we don't see the hard work that goes into preparing a message. We ask God to bring it to us through the Holy Spirit. We know that He's our counselor. It's not about my thoughts, because the Bible says that His thoughts are higher than my thoughts. You see, when we plan out stuff, guess what? We always mess it up. Amen? We actually prepare something, it never turns out the way we want it. Why? Because guess what? We planned it the way we wanted it. But God says, no, 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 I know what I'm doing. And sometimes it looks like crazy. Man, how did this happen? But God has a way, because He's a sovereign God. He knows all things. He reminds me of a GPS when we're lost. Did you know that you can never get lost when you have a GPS? Because you can punch in the destination, and that destination will be charted out for you. Did you know that? But sometimes, like us men, we say, I don't want to follow that destination. I want to go to the next destination. I want to turn on this street. Well, then guess what the GPS says? It says, okay, Eddie, I'm going to take you that way, but I'm going to take you in a different route. So it's up to us to follow the route that He's given us. Amen? So we can go in circles and circles, but until we surrender to the GPS, which is God, we will actually get to our destination. Amen? And as we look at this picture that Pat is going to do for me, she's going to put a picture of a Rolls Royce. And the reason I wanted to put the picture of a Rolls Royce is because I started looking and started researching, and the picture of a Rolls Royce, or actual car, some of those cars start out at $700,000. Did you know that? Somebody say, wow. $700,000. But you know what? I looked at some Rolls Royce has even peaked to $20 million. They were made out of gold. Do you know that? And the reason I want you to see a picture of this is because you'll connect the dots in a little bit. But it says, it seemed that there was a man in England who put his Rolls Royce on a boat and he went across to the continent to go on a holiday trip. While he was driving around Europe, something happened to the motor of his car. He cabled the Rolls Royce company. And he asked them, I'm having trouble with my car. What do you suggest I do? Well, the Rolls Royce people flew a mechanic overseas. The mechanic repaired the car and flew back to England and left the man to continue his holiday. The fellow was wondering all through his holiday, how much is this going to cost me? So when he got back to England, he wrote the people a letter and asked how much he owed them. He received a letter back from the office, and it read this: "Dear sir, there is no records anywhere on our files that anything ever happened to that Rolls-Royce." You see, and this is what we have in Christ Jesus. In Christ, it is as there was nothing ever wrong with us. It is called justification. It is called salvation. It's all about Him. My sermon on the title today is Junk to Justify, Rags to Riches. And as we bow our heads in reverence to the Lord, I just ask God that His Holy Spirit would press down on us this morning. And I pray that everybody be attentive to this message. But you have to have an open heart. So as we bow our heads, we pray for the Lord to just be here in His presence, that He would use me to speak life into any situations in our lives. Father, I just ask you to give us a clean heart so that we may serve you. Lord, let our hearts be fixed on what you have for our lives. We have so many blessings we can't even count. Lord, give us a heart that we can follow you. Lord, when we find ourselves in the dungeon of life and asking so many questions to fix a problem the way we want to fix, forgive us for that, Lord God. You're sovereign God. You know what's best for us. Lord, you know the way we should take, Father God. We ask you in the name of Jesus Christ that your Holy Spirit press down upon us, Lord, that you would open our hearts to reveal your history to us, Lord God, your history of your Son dying on the cross for us, Lord God, and taking away the sins of this earth, Lord. I just thank you again for everyone represented, Lord, that we would just fully comprehend what you have in store for them today, Father God. We thank you, we love you, in Jesus' name, and everyone said, amen. As we open up our Bibles to Jeremiah 18, verse 1 through 6. Jeremiah 18, verse 1 through 6. I'll read. It says, "The Lord which came to Jeremiah from the Lord, saying, Arise and go down to the potter's house, and there I will cause you to hear my words. Then I went down to the potter's house, and there he was, making something at the wheel. And the vessel that he made of clay was there in the hand of the potter. So he made it again into another vessel, and it seemed good to the potter to make. Then the word of the Lord came to me, saying, O house of Israel, can I not do with you as this potter, says the Lord? Look, as the clay is in the potter's hands, so are you in my hands, O house of Israel." As we turn to 2 Corinthians 5, 2 Corinthians 5, verse 12 through 21, it reads like this: "For we do not commend ourselves again to you, but give you opportunity to boast on our behalf, that you may have answer for those who boast in appearance and not in heart. For if we are beside ourselves, it is for God. Or as if we are of sound mind, it is for you." Verse 14. "For the love of Christ compels us, because we judge us, that if one died for all, then all died." 15. "And he died for all, that those who live should live no longer for themselves, but for him who died for them and rose again. Therefore, from now on, we regard no one according to the flesh. Even though we have known Christ according to the flesh, yet now we know him that no longer." Verse 17, listen to this: "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Now all things are of God, who has reconciled us to himself through Jesus Christ, and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. That is, that God was in Christ, reconciling the world to himself, not imputing their trespasses to them, and has committed to us a word of reconciliation. Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God were pleading through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God, for he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. Amen. That's a good word, because that's an encouragement to each and every one of us that we have a purpose in life. And that purpose is that if you accepted Christ as Lord and Savior, guess what? All those things that you did in the past, they're in the past. Everything now, as Pastor Renee was sharing with the people that are going to be baptized, it means that they're stepping into something new. How many of you like things new? I don't know about you, but I love new parachutes, right? I know many of you like that dress that's new, right? We all like the smell of the car when it's new. So you have to understand that God has made you new in him. Amen? And then I'd like to show you another picture of something that I started thinking about when my kids were very, very young. They should always say, Dad, put on the TV, you know, my best show is coming on. And as you look at this, you'll know what I'm talking about. You see, so when you think of the word transform, many thoughts come to mind. So as my children were young, they would want to be transformers. You know, they would act like it, they would ask for the costume. You understand what I'm saying, right? You want the costume, and before you know it, they think they're turning into all kinds of, oh, I'm Bumblebee, and I don't know Bumblebee, but I'm this, and I'm that. And you look at them, and you smile, because guess what? They're trying to become something bigger, better, and stronger. And that's exactly what we have an opportunity to do. Become bigger, and better, and stronger. And as you think about this, we think about the words we just read from Paul, that he penned to the church of Corinth. We can almost feel his excitement when he's writing this letter. He is saying to us, we may have life, but we have it in abundance. Regardless of our previous state, because Jesus would not come down from the cross, because we were set in our own ways in sin, God says, I want to reconnect you because you're disconnected. Do you see that? He wanted to reconnect us because we didn't have passions to him. There was a big gap between us and him. But he says, whoever was disconnected, now you're reconnected. And guess what? You're at a better rate than AT&T and Sprint can ever push you. You see? Because he ultimately paid the price. Amen? So because of this, we are now new creations. A wonderful change, a new beginning, another change of the reconciliation between our God. You see? So it's the reconnection of our disconnection. It is from doom to disgrace to delivered by grace. I didn't even know I mean that, but let me say it again. The doom to disgrace to delivered by grace. From Rome to rescue. From junk to justify. From rags to riches. Amen? How many of us here were rags? If you don't understand, it's like a sister over here, Erica, she was sitting down and she said, Pastor, what does rags mean? I said, you're looking at one right here. I used to be a dirty rag. But guess what? The Word of God says that he has brought his righteousness on me. So now I'm rich. Amen? In other words, we are brand new. 1 Corinthians 2:9 says, the living word of God declares, eyes have not seen, nor ear has heard, nor have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who love him. You see that? When you love God with all your heart and you focus everything on him to say, God, whatever I have, I'm going to give it to you. God said he will open doors. He will open opportunity for you. He will have favor on you. You will be successful in whatever you do. It doesn't matter if you're cleaning the toilet. He will lift you up before men. 1 Corinthians 2:10-12, it says, God has revealed to them